A battle rapper is supposed to successfully dismantle his opponent, whether it be through the art of rapping, whether it be making fun of their character, their appearance, in some cases their entire life saga and past. Whatever you feel is the best way to assassinate somebody's character, basically.
A rap battler battles people in rap.
I actually said no at first because of how good Cruger is and because I would like to give myself like the proper time to prepare for somebody as like smart and creative as him. He's not the type of person that I just had a bunch of stock ideas and lines ready for right off the bat, like you do with other people, because there's other people that are just easier targets.
Yeah, I think it's just I'm battling him at the right time. I think it's easier because I've known about him for so long as well. I find it easier writing for him. So I've known about him for a long time. We've got a long history. Yeah, and he's always given me like a lot of props and shown a lot of, said he's raised my style and stuff. So I've always found that like as a big compliment, really.
I have a lot of respect for Cruger. He's my favorite in the UK. I've been saying that for a while. I've been, declaring him the best out there, which, I guess is up for debate. But what I like about him is that he never takes a typical or predictable approach. He's very creative and witty. His word selection and choices are really original. His setups he doesn't set himself up for the most predictable lines in the world, which is always something good. Like, I look for that in other battlers. Just a really smart, creative kid, and he deserves a real opportunity, I think. So, let's go, son.
Hey, yo, King of the Dot, put your money where your mouth is. Los Angeles, Vendetta, make some noise, yo. Organic, follow us on Twitter at King of the Dot, at Organic Hip Hop, KOTDStore.com, Ustream.tv/King of the Dot. Shout out to everyone watching the Ustream.
Yeah, Gully TK, go to YouTube.com/Ground Zero Battles, add, subscribe. Hit me up if you're trying to get in King of the Dot on Twitter at Gully TK. That's what's up, baby. Let's go.
Much Rock and Plex One.
It's your boy Plex Rock. I'm back.
Cindy Dean and Billy Home.
Making history, dubs up. Rapper to my right, former King of the Dot champion, introduce yourself.
What's good? Thesaurus, two-time everything. Big shout out, legendaryclothingcompany.com. I got hard copies of the album here tonight. Cop that shit. All I know is that.
You're a patron!
All the way from the UK, representing Don't Flop. Rapper to my left, introduce yourself.
Cruger. Shout out to everyone watching this live back home.
Make sure you go YouTube.com/Don't Flop. Check out the UK battle scene. Eurgh, Cruger, they're all doing it big. Much love to them. The Saurus won the coin toss. It is 90 seconds on Cruger. Vendetta, let's fucking go.
You're so arrogant, your website's called Thesaurus Wins. Your email's World Rap Champion. Your clothing's legendary. Yeah. You're the king. It's like you're telling us what we ought to think, but most people just see a fat loser with awful skin. You're black at everything. Your music's such a sad, depressing thing, it will probably turn Hollohan back to heroin. Your facial expressions make you look like a fucking weirdo. It's like you have a mental twitch. It's like you have Tourette's. Your tick is to make your face uglier than it already is. The faces you pull just get me pissed. There's no need to screw your face up. God already did. I hate looking at your face when I spit. I hope whichever camera angle that captures your mangled face reacting to this battle corrupts when they edit this. He's competitive at everything. I bet even when you play with your daughter, you never let her win in board games and cheat in every card game. So quit this world rap champion attitude, Illmaculate carried you. You're a baddest goose of a rapper. Don't act like you gambled too, because you split the money in the finals when they handed you wax and juice. Out of everyone there, you split 50 grand with the whackers too. What kind of gambling man are you? I find it odd you even started panicking that you'd lose and wouldn't gamble in the easiest battle you had to do. But I think you need to gamble less, because if you keep on having bets, you'll overload and won't be the only Greek in massive debt. And the tracks that you do are even fucking wacker than usual. I know you respect me, but the respect we have isn't mutual. If you have your CD for free, I'll be happy you do, so I can throw that shit on the ground and give it my stamp of approval.
Your cunt friends. Your shirt says silence is golden, so shut the fuck up then. Yeah, it's Freddy Krueger, London native. Some would say you're underrated. This is like putting The Rock against, it doesn't matter what your name is. Let's talk about your alter ego, just in case it doesn't make it. He's more like Harvey Dent. You got a couple faces like a double agent. Battle rap comedian? Horrorcore stage performer, necro worshiper, painting portraits of rape and torture. In mom's basement, screaming angry towards your tape recorder, bitches all describe Cruger with two words, restraining order. Now, I don't believe a word you say. He isn't very threatening. He's just introverted, skinny Freddy. Shit is real depressing. Now, in Britain, they'll be checking the obituary section because the blade is leaving crew cut like a military veteran. Now, you real soft, but you still talking. With kill shots, I'm a real problem. Taking your bread, plating his head from the meal cart you get wheeled off in. If it's real close, then I will rob him till I feel gold like I'm Phil Dawson. And if he ain't got nothing to steal off him, I'ma steal on him. Now fuck Phil Collins, I'm Phil Jackson, bitch. Let me show you how. A player from another era going back to coaching now. I hold the crown. What, you think you can expose me, clown? Gonna talk about my broken down ex-bitch in your closing round? Look, he's panicking. That info wasn't supposed to be found. It was sorry, pussy. All I had to do was show me around. This is my one time slowing it down. I said, sorry, pussy. All I had her do was show me around.
Your album's called All I Know Is That. I don't know the tracks, all I know is that. But we all know old Matt makes a sick of music, and since he never puts you on, you put him on some shit that you did. So you finally done a track. I guess he ran out of his excuses and thought if it's on a Saurus album, at least no one will listen to it. More successful rappers to battle, it's obvious they're doing it as a step before they get their song on the air. Battling for 10 years or any longer is rare. You're stuck on the first step. You're too fat to even climb metaphorical stairs. Your clothes stretch because they're tight, whatever the size. The only thing you fit is the American stereotype. Plus your facial texture is like an American pie. I'm talking the one that got fucked in American Pie. You ain't swag dripping, you're sweat dripping. You're a fat sweaty troll with man breasts. Bad breath to go with your bad breath control. But the way you fall in love with every chick you met explains your breath control in battles. I guess they take your breath away. Yo. His ex was Canadian. His last girlfriend was Australian. You get whipped outside of your own country like racism. And underage girls are the only ones dating them because they got something in common. Problems with facial skin. at least before you get the engagement ring, you can talk to their parents on a level because you'll be the same age as them. You claim you win, but you lose respect every time. You lose your voice every battle and lose your breath every line. Going Oz all the time, you're losing your mind. You're such a loser, you fly 8,000 miles to lose battles for loose pussy. You're losing in life. He's a 19-year-old Australian battle groupie. It's stupid that you love them. But now you've got beef, because real talk, Uno Lavos fucked her. She said when she came to visit, you locked her in a house to stop her coming out. You don't have a job and spend all day slobbing on the couch. Her family hated you and never wanted you around. I could continue, but I need a lot longer than a round.
Hell, bringing up my ex-chick isn't going too far. Uno told me he didn't fuck her, so either one of you's a lying bitch or both of you are. Now you need to check yourself. I ain't never held up. Lesson dealt, every hole in your head is swelled shut. Freddy Krueger fares well with the fairy tale stuff, but his whole set disappears once the director yells, cut. Oh. Please cue the theme music. Your entire scene's stupid, be real. We ain't wasting this clip, so let's reshoot it. Dude, you finished. Actor studio, you just a student in it. I'll pick apart this Freddy Krueger gimmick like a movie critic. See, he catches people sleeping. That's kind of a known thing. So I kept that shit in mind when designing my whole theme. I'm Kruger's idol. So tonight I provided a smoke screen to finally kill Freddy inside of his own dream. Now look, I'm wide awake for y'all to witness this sunning. A heart-to-heart talk about the man he isn't becoming. Should it be funny if you really were considering ducking, since history done proved that the British are nothing? Now let me finish discussing how much I hate Freddy Krueger. My name's Reggie Miller, I'm the game-ending shooter. This day couldn't have came any sooner. I'm a plane headed through you like it's aimed at the Trade Center, Krueger. I'm fat cause I stay fed, J. Edgar Hoover. It ain't any rumor, I'm taking away Freddy's future. We don't have the same sense of humor. Your punches are a joke, mine are Mayweather Jr.'s.
You are the corniest human being alive. You need a reminder. With cheeks looking like you're smoked weed till you're tired, then fall asleep on the grinder. Wake up later that evening on fire, cause your face hit the flint and started dripping in grease to the lighter. And in every battle you say, you're a faggot. That soon got to end. You made the word faggot so uncool, you do not offend. In fact, you're probably the gay community's friend, because you've turned people like me off ever wanting to use it again. You're the biggest scam. Your battle with Matt Lethal was like how acrobats catch people in any trick they land, because every flip was planned. When he was king of the dot, he couldn't zip his track. Hollohan put up his chain on the day, so boasting about it's pretty sad considering it wasn't a company's decision, and when you got it, you couldn't defend it for one single match. Two-time winner of everything? What kind of everything is that? You couldn't even get a win against the guy to win a chance to win it back. That's because all the angles you take fall flat on your face. When you battled PH, you rap about his age. Said he's fat, out of shape, trying to hang on to fame. Doesn't deserve a match for the chain. Only relevant back in the day, the fact that his name carries no weight. Wait. Fat, old, washed up, and desperate for the title. You and his problems sound exactly the same. Two-time winner of everything? What about everything that you're losing? What about Dizzle Mac or Richie Yaz? Who do you think that you're fooling? When you won Scribble and Jump Off, it was a different movement. You're not the two-time winner of everything, you're the winner of two things. 5 years ago, and both of them competitions got ruined because everyone freed and you were using writings to do them. So it's all a big hoax, but I'll put an end to the myth you're pursuing, because this ain't the first time I came to the West to kill an illusion.
Look! Yeah. 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 Yo! Yo! We're perfect instances of why not to judge a book by its cover. But I'm still thankful as fuck that we don't look like each other. How do you look like a pedophile and an adolescent child? Vagina gets a second smile. But somehow, for one of us to win this, it's a good look. I said, somehow, I think that I can win this with my good looks. Yo, see, he's too shook to talk to women. Cruger gets embarrassed all day. Bitches exit stage left whenever Freddy stares a Broadway. It's beyond gay to write verses about whores I fornicated. My pipe's staying up in organs like a Portland native. For you, talking to bitches is a foreign language. This faggot should have been aborted before he was ever born in Cambridge. I thought you'd be more creative or bring some shit that was new. 30 Englishmen are with him. Not a single chick in the coop. And it's cool, but let's put things in perspective. You live in England, my dick has been in more English women than you. Now, speaking of vaginas, don't flop or cunts. Y'all need to stop the front. I'm sick of all your stunts. I almost lost my lunch. A Grand Prix? A magazine? Your champion's an obnoxious drunk? How about come up with your own thoughts and don't bite King of the Dot for once? Oh! I mean, what's next, guys? Don't flop Fresh Coast Division? Let me guess, mom jokes are what the West Coast is missing? That means the planet wasn't three quarters water.
King of the Dot, put your money where your mouth is. Vendetta, Thesaurus, Cruger, make some noise, y'all. Yeah. Judges came to a decision. The winner of the battle, Thesaurus.
Yeah, hey, big up to Cruger, man. The best in England. I said it. It's a fact.
What up? Cap Callis, Ozone, Florida, Smash City Gauntlet. Bang. You know what it is. Over here. You know, I hate when people say you know what it is, because maybe you don't. I'm judging Cruger versus Thesaurus. I thought it was a really great battle, one of Cruger's best showings. I did vote for Thesaurus. I burped into the microphone. I think Thesaurus edged it 2-1. I think Thesaurus got the first two rounds, and Cruger definitely got the third. But I thought the second round was really, really close. The one thing that I had that I thought was like a little off for Cruger, which I wasn't expecting from him, is he kind of went for the obvious, and it was all like a lot of face jokes and like, your face was on a grinder and then there was oil, and it's like, you know, to me, that's always going for the obvious. And like, I thought it was really, really ill that Thesaurus decided to go like, you know, a little further outside of that. And he had also the one thing that really affected the decision for me, which I think might have been what lost the battle for Cruger, was not necessarily content, but was delivery. There was like a little bit of shakiness in a couple of his rounds, and like there was a point where he actually like lost his composure, and you can tell that Thesaurus was just totally comfortable through the whole thing. And like, to me, like, you know, like if you're going all the way across like, you know, the ocean to battle and come to someone's front door, like you gotta come out swinging and just be like, fuck that, I'm here to win. And I think it was obvious that Thesaurus was just like comfortable, and he was like, yeah, I'm gonna get in your face. He didn't stumble once. It was a clean performance, and Cruger was a little shaky. So that's why I think it went to Thesaurus, but a really, really close battle. And in all honesty, I'm sure it'll be debated online. Shout out to both the MCs, man. They killed it, man. So props to y'all. Peace.
What's good? It's your boy, Cole Cat, Mad Mike, whatever you want to call me. On Fire Entertainment. Shout out to my team back home in Seattle. All right. So we just got on watching Cruger versus Thesaurus. It was a last minute battle put together, I think about a month ago or so. Both of the dudes were spitting crazy. Cruger was witty as hell, like he always is. Thesaurus came with a different approach, a little bit more, with more anger. I did give it to Thesaurus. I thought every round he edged Cruger out a little bit. So yeah, that was my decision. Thesaurus.
What's up, y'all? Lord Harmy from Game of Thrones. We just saw Thesaurus, Cruger. Very, very dope battle. I gave it to Thesaurus. I break it down like this. The first two rounds were really, really hard for me to judge. Both of them had clever schemes, some hard-hitting bars, crazy-ass punchlines. But it came down to that third round, and in that third, just I thought Thesaurus body-bagged that. Like, that's all I can really say about that. Like, you'll see the footage for yourself. He just went in. And I think the more stuff that he was saying was more factual, some of the stuff that Cruger was saying. Could have been facts, could have been not really, we don't know. So at the end of the day, Thesaurus took that 2-1. It is what it is, King of the Vendetta. Shout out to all the MCs that took part so far. Like, I gotta do it again, I fucked up.
Go ahead, man.
All right. I need some water. Yeah, all right. Sup, y'all, Lord Hami, Game of Thrones. You know what it is, King of the Vendetta, Los Angeles, California. We just saw Thesaurus and Cruger, really tight battle. First two rounds, I thought could have gone either way. Both of them had sick punchlines, had clever schemes, and whatever they were saying was either factual or not. It came down to me picking Thesaurus, especially in the third round. I thought what he was saying was really body-bag material. He had hard-hitting punches, and you know, he took the W. He really earned that one. But shout out to Cruger, flew all the way from London just to be here. He did his thing. It is what it is, King of the Vendetta, and I'm out. Peace.
All right, your boy Reverence here at Vendetta, fucking West Coast, LA, all day. Just judged Cruger versus the Source. And it was pretty close. The first two rounds were pretty close, but I edged them both to the Source. Cruger came really good, but a lot of stuff he said, like, I don't have no like proof if that shit's real or not about the girlfriends, and he mentioned Uno Labo, so like, I don't know if none of that's true, but that's what I based it on, and the stuff the Source was saying, I know is true facts. Like, I was feeling the way he went at his whole camp, like the Don't Flop camp, but shout out to those dudes, those are good dudes. But I was just feeling the Source. I think his experience shined a bit more, and in the third round, the Source like body bagged that. That was, Kruger's third round was nice too, but I think the Source body bagged that third round, so swayed my decision his way, you know?
All right. Yo, what's up? Synchronized, Mike Masters, Mr. Bending Records, 801, Salt Lake City, King of the Dot, Fresh Coast. Just got done watching Cruger and Thesaurus. First round, Cruger came out probably the best. I don't want to be cliche and say it like that, but he came out really, really, really tough and really just like, you fucking suck in the first round. And it was just really ugly. Thesaurus came a little lag, had a little lag. He was very about it, but a very lag. Round one, Cruger. Round two, Thesaurus. Yo, the Freddy Cruger lines, too much. Like honestly, like I understand like hitting them with a, like what Cruger was hitting with a, you know, looking like American Pie. That was outrageous. That was outrageous. Thesaurus really, really flipped that and made like everything about him. With that said, big ups to Don't Flop. Third round, Thesaurus. That's how I called it, 2-1. First round, Cruger, next two rounds, Thesaurus. With that said, 2-1, Thesaurus. Big ups to Cruger, big ups to Don't Flop, big ups to King of the Dot, big ups to fucking battle.
Thesaurus here, just finished my battle with Cruger here at Vendetta. What an event so far. It is very hot. Great battle, for sure. Cruger is always a very smart and creative writer. That's like one of the main reasons I accepted the battle, because I really expect his creativity and his wittiness. I tried to combat that being a little more hard-bodied instead of just trying to match his jokes and his overall wit, because that is not a smart choice to take against somebody as good as him. Took a risk because it's a chess game, so you start thinking about the other player's moves. In talking to a female friend before the battle, like a week ago, she kind of triggered a thought to me where she was like, I think I might get brought up in a battle. And I go, you know, I think something from my past might get brought up in a battle. So it was good because I was ready for what hit me, which sort of deflated the sails in his ship when he delivered the line, because people kind of saw it coming since I saw it coming. And yeah, got to think outside the box for these type of things. Took it pretty seriously. Definitely happy with the outcome. We in here. Much love. King of the Dot. Copy album. Thesauruswins.bandcamp. All I know is that. Peace.
Yo, what's up? This is Cruger. Just got out of the battle with Thesaurus. Great battle, man. It was really intense. Yeah, it was a good battle, both sides, man. I felt like a really nervous getting into this one, and kind of like I messed up a start, messed up on a few bars. It kind of threw me off, but then when I messed up in my first round, I thought I've got to, you know, get into the zone for my next one. So I think I brought it back. But yeah, man, it was a I think it was a good battle.